Hey all, welcome back to the series of Java programming. We have already seen in the last program about a nested if, and we have also checked how we can put multiple conditions inside one if. This will be the fifth program. Here we will be working on for loop. We will see how for loop works in Java. This concept will be applicable for other programming languages as well. Maybe the indentation and the way of the syntax will be different. Okay, let's go through it. So here we will start in the Eclipse. Here we have a class named hello. We have a main method, string args is there. Okay, we have already seen these basic things because a Java program starts from the main method. So we will write our code inside it. So for loop, we have to write keyword for. Now we have to initialize a variable, let's say I equal to 0. So I, we will put a condition less than equal to 10, I plus plus, and we will open and close the curly bracket. Always keep this in practice, that whenever you open a curly bracket, close it at that time only, so that you don't forget to mention any curly bracket, right? Because if you have opened it, then you have to definitely close it. So what we have done here, we have just put a variable I, we have declared it as integer type, and we have provided the value as 0. The first one is the initialization and declaration. Okay, here what we have done, we have put a condition of I less than or equal to 10. And what is here? Here is I plus plus. That means it is incrementing the value of I. So in for loop, we have three things. First, initialization. Second, condition. Third, increment or decrement according to our choice, whatever we want to do. Okay. So what we will do inside it, if let's say we print the value of I, system dot out dot print, and what we will print, value of I. So let's see how this program will execute. First, main method. Okay, whatever the program will be written inside the main method, it will execute. So main method is from here till here. It will come to the line number 7. Compiler will check that for is written. That means it is a for loop. It will check that I is declared as integer type and its value is 0. I less than equal to 10. So it will first initialize the value as 0. Let me put in the comment. First time I will be 0. Condition will be checked. Yes, condition is true. 0 less than equal to 10. When the condition will be true, it will come inside. Inside the for loop, that means this blue part, and it will execute the code. What will happen? System dot out dot print, that means it will print. What it will print? Value of I. What is the value of I? Right now 0. Let me write the output here. So for the first time, value of I will be 0. Okay, so 0 will be printed. I will only type the value here. Again, what will happen? It will come here. Since this line is executed, it will come here and it will check, oh, it is closed. Then again, it will go back to the for loop and it will now jump to this section, I plus plus. It will increment the value. What will be the value of I now? 1. Now, after incrementing the value, it will come here. It will check the condition. What is the condition? I less than equal to 10. So the value of I is 1. Is it less than equal to 10? Yes. What will happen? Condition true, come inside. Now it will execute this code. It will not go to this section, that I equal to 0. This will be used only for the first time for declaration and initialization of the value. Okay, it will not execute again. So here incremented, condition checked, and then print. What it will print? Value of I. What is value of I now? 1. Okay. Again, this is closed. It will go up. Increment the value. What is the value? What was the earlier value? 1. What will be the new value? I++. I++ means I equal to I+1. So now the value of I will be 2. After incrementing, what will happen? It will check the condition. This one. I < 10. So what is the condition true? Yes, 2 > 10. Condition true, it will go inside the for loop and execute the code. What it is doing? Printing. What printing? Value of I. What is the value of I this time? 2. Again, it will go up. Increment the value. I will be 3. I > 10. Yes. Will execute it. 3. So like that, it will go and print 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Let's say it come to 9. As soon as 9 is printed, it will go up. I++ will happen. That means value will be 10. Okay. And then it will come here. So it will check the condition I > 10. That means 10 > 10. Is it true? Yes. It is not less, but equal is true. Okay, good. That means this condition, equal condition satisfied. So if the condition is true, it will come inside the for loop and it will execute the code. Here it is written print I. So what will happen? It will print 10. Okay, what will happen now? It will go again above. It will increment the value. Value will be 11 because I++ is there. 10 will be incremented by 1. So value will be 11. Now here it will check. 11 > 10? No. It is neither less nor equal. Hence condition failed. As soon as the condition will be failing, the loop will terminate and it will come outside the loop. Outside the loop means here, this will be the outside loop and it will come to the next line. So the loop will keep on executing till this condition will meet. Okay. Since when the last value was 10, it will increment it to 11, condition will be failed and it will go out of the loop. And here nothing is written, nothing is written, program closed. So let's try to first run it and we'll confirm whether the output is exactly the same or not. So yeah, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So since it is printing in sequence line, in a sequence, so I will make it print in different line. So for that, what we have to do, we have to just put ln. Ln means new line. So now it will be printing in a new line, 0, 1, 2, 3, like that, yeah, till 10. So this is the smallest program of the for loop where we can run the loop till as much we want. We can make it as 100 also. We can start it from 1 also. So like that, it will be printing. Let me show you if we do it for 100. So all the numbers will be printed till 100, like that. So this is how for loop works. Hope you understood the concept. Thank you for watching. Keep practicing, keep revising.